Hi, have you ever wondered about the best strategies to select between climb and conventional milling? I'm Alexios Chiasos and today we're going to talk about the cases when it's better to select the one over the other. First of all, if you don't already know about the difference between climb and conventional milling, I strongly advise you to go to our website, cncseminars.com, where you can find an article about this topic. In this article, you will learn about the pros and cons of each strategy, and you will be able to distinguish when to use the one over the other. Okay, to begin with, it has to be noted that if you are a conventional machinist, you may think that conventional milling is the way to go, or on the other hand, if you are a CNC machinist, you may think that climb milling is your only option. However, we will see that both options are very useful for CNC machining, and the final selection depends on the machining task we have to face. Climb milling is usually the way to go for the generality of machining cases. During climb milling, the teeth of the cutting tool directly engage with the material without rubbing, and this results in better dimensional accuracy on the final part, better life expectancy of the cutting tool, and lower power consumption during machining. Also, the direct engagement of the cutting tool teeth with the material prevents the work hardening of the surface of the final part. On the other hand, conventional milling may produce parts with poor dimensional accuracy because of the initial rubbing of the tool on the cutting surface. However, the geometric accuracy of the final part is higher because the cutting forces are almost parallel to the cut. Also, given the direction of the cutting forces during conventional milling, it has to be noted that this strategy can be successfully applied on thin-walled parts. Also, an additional case that conventional milling can be proven very useful is for side milling of surface hardened parts, because in conventional milling the chip formation starts below the surface of the part. Finally, it has to be mentioned that despite the fact that conventional milling produces parts with poor surface quality due to the less effective chip evacuation, sometimes it's our only option whenever we have to operate machine tools with significant backlash on their axis. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to learn more about the difference between climb and conventional milling, you can go to our website, cncseminars.com, where you can find the relevant article on this topic. Also, you can find the link to this article in the description below. Moreover, if you have any comments or any questions, you can comment below. And of course, if you like this video, you can give us a thumbs up. And if you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe to our channel and share this video to other social media platforms so as to help this channel grow. And last but not least, you can go to our social media accounts where you can find the content we upload. That's it for today, and see you next time.